I recently moved into a new home, so naturally, I needed to model the new place in Revit. Honestly, I've done this for every house I've ever lived in, usually weeks before I actually arrive. Hats off to every leasing agent I've ever had who let me wander around for an hour taking measurements. The first pass is always a fast pass. I don't care about the roof or HVAC or anything like that. My first pass is so I can figure out where my furniture goes. As we all know, it's much easier to move furniture around in CAD than in real life. I'll regularly revisit the model while I live there to add details, but in the beginning, I just want a basic layout. The default Revit families are usually good enough at this stage. But this time, I needed a shape that wasn't available in the default library. I needed a U-shaped countertop. Revit comes with a number of countertop shapes, but not any U-shaped ones. We're going to have to make one. But as I've said many times on this channel and in class, I'm pretty lazy, which means I'm going to cheat a little to save time. In today's episode, we're going to learn how to edit a simple Revit family. Since I'm not going to start from scratch, I'm going to start with the closest family that I can find. In this case, I need a U-shaped countertop with a sink opening. The closest to that is the L-shaped countertop with sink family. So let's open that up. As soon as we open it, we need to save as the family to a new name. I like to put my new families in my own library folder to keep track of the models I've created for my house. As you can see, I haven't needed to make any countertops so far. Whenever you are working with an existing family, it pays to spend a few minutes exploring how it was created. Here we can see that the main flat portion of the countertop is a single extrusion, and the backsplashes for each edge are separate extrusions. Easy enough. Because we want to be able to edit the size of the countertop within the project model, we have to add a few new reference planes. A new plane for the right side countertop depth, width, and backsplash is all we need. For the depth of the countertop, we will apply a dimension. Then, we will associate it with the existing depth parameter so it matches the existing counter. For the backsplash, we can just dimension and lock the reference plane. It's not my intention to change it in the model. For the width, we will add a new dimension, and this time, name a new parameter. When dimensioning, make sure you're dimensioning to the reference planes whenever you have a choice. You can tap the Tab key to cycle between options. Now that we have our basic geometry laid out, it's a simple matter of editing the existing countertop extrusion. Click on it and choose Edit Extrusion in the ribbon. We can use the Pick Line tool to select our reference planes. Don't forget to lock the lines or use the Lock option in the Options bar. And use the Trim to Corner tool to clean up the corners. For the extra backsplash, we do have a couple of options. We could easily add geometry to the existing extrusion, but since the original has each backsplash separate, we'll do the same. Create a new extrusion. In this case, I'm simply going to draw a rectangle and make sure I lock everything in place. I never really set an extrusion height. Rather, I'll go into an elevation view and drag the top and bottom to the appropriate reference plane and lock them that way. To clean up the final model, we need to use Join Geometry so it looks like a single solid model. Easy. The generic Revit family doesn't really have a good material set for it, and for my application, I'm not super worried about it. I will add materials later on as the model gets refined, so I don't particularly care. That said, I did create a new extrusion, and the material of that extrusion needs to be associated to the material parameter of the family. Being kind to your future self is always important. All right. Now it's time to save the family once again and load it into the project to test it out. Looks like we didn't actually do anything. What's up with that? Taking a look at a 3D view of the countertop can help us identify the issue. Ah, a rookie mistake. I didn't check the visibility settings. They used a 2D top-down view, and I missed it. I should have known that merge line has been getting in the way the whole time. Going back to the family, we can click on the merge line object and start editing it. We only need to use pick lines and lock those lines in order to get our geometry in the right place while remaining flexible. With that last change, we can save our family once more and load it back into the project. Give it a little test, and hooray! We're finished. Editing an existing family is almost always faster than building something from scratch, especially if it is for early in the modeling phase. It'll be easy to add new detail as you need to. If you found this video helpful, press the like button for SEO reasons I don't fully understand. You could also email it to a coworker. That'd be cool. Do people still do that? They do, right? If you have any questions or suggestions for future videos, leave them below. Be sure to hit subscribe if you'd like to get notified of new videos. And of course, if you're interested in any of our AutoCAD, Revit, Inventor, Civil 3D, 3DS, Max, SketchUp, MicroStation classes, you'll find the link below. In particular, you might enjoy our 2-day Revit BIM Family Management class, where it teaches you in more depth how to create your own Revit families. As always, I'm David, and happy CADing.